In SN2 reaction, alkyl halide methyl bromide reacts with nucleophile. In such process, Na plus combined with the Br replaced as a NaBr. In the place of halogen, the nucleophile is substituted. We get methyl alcohol. So this is the nucleophile. Here OH minus is nothing but nucleophile. That nucleophile substituted in the place of halogen, so that is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. Here, leaving group is a halogen. Leaving group is a halogen. Now here, it is an SN2 or SN1. How do we are identified? See, very simple. Generally, this reaction takes place through single step. Why it takes place single step? Because. So here, alkyl halide. It is a methyl bromide. Just see. Methyl bromide. CH3Br. The nucleophile attack front side or back side? Which side attacking is favorable here?
Back side.
Very good. Back side attacking more favorable. Why? Because front side halogen is there. Halogen charge negative. The coming nucleophile charge also negative. Because of that reason, front side attack, it will oppose, somewhat difficult. So here, the nucleophile attack from back side. Okay, halogen ko opposite side, it will attack slowly. This reaction is a slow reaction. The slow step is also called rate determining step. The slow step is called rate determining step. Here the carbon hybridization sp3. First here, how do the reaction takes place? First, the nucleophile partially formed bond with the carbon. At the same time, carbon halogen bond partially breaking. Bond forming and bond breaking both are take simultaneously. Bond forming and bond breaking both are takes simultaneously. So this state is called transition state. What we can say? Transition state. Transition state means it is a complete unstable state and more reactive. Unstable. Okay, high energetic. So immediately, rapidly, fastly it is converted into, see, carbon halogen bond partially, okay, here breaking, but here completely breaking. Then carbon nucleophile bond completely formed to form methyl alcohol. What is the hybridization here? SP3. So this configuration is also called Walden inversion configuration. What is called Walden inversion configuration? Reverse umbrella type. Okay, if you are observed reactant and product. Reactant may outgoing halogen here, right side is there. But product may the incoming nucleophile that is present left side. So this type of configurations are called Walden inversion configuration. Okay, opposite. With respect to reactant, leaving group is present right side, but with respect to product, the incoming nucleophile is present left side. This is called Walden inversion configuration. Now see. So it is enough up to this. Okay, here this reaction takes place through single step. So in this step, the slow step is called what we can say rate determining step. Rate determining step, how many molecules are participate? Two. One is the nucleophile, other one is the methyl bromide. Both molecules are there. So it is called bimolecular, molecularity two. So bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. What is the order?
Two.
Very good. If we can take according to chemical kinetics, rate of reaction, so rate is directly proportional to the product of nucleophile concentration and tertiary, okay, nucleophile concentration and methyl bromide concentration. Two concentrations lena hai. Rate equals to K into donon concentrations. Powers liya to 1 plus 1, 2. So it is called second order nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, now here one point. Primary alkyl halides are favorable for SN2 reaction. Now SN1, listen. If we can take SN1 reaction, what about that? See? SN2, see, methyl bromide is nothing but alkyl halide, OH minus, it is a nucleophile. Now reacts, it is a outgoing, here Br minus. Now here we get the methyl alcohol. This is the SN2. Now SN1, let you. SN1. What about SN1 reaction? Okay, let's see. One minute. Okay, if we can take SN1 reaction. So, with respect to SN1 reaction, see, I have taken one example here. SN1 reaction. If tertiary alkyl halide, I have taken tertiary alkyl halide. What is called tertiary alkyl halide? See, tertiary butyl bromide, I have taken tertiary butyl bromide. Okay, now tertiary butyl bromide. See, tertiary butyl bromide reacts with nucleophile OH minus. Same, I have given a nucleophile given. OH minus nucleophile given. See, tertiary butyl bromide is a 1 degree or 2 degree or 3 degree alkyl halide?
3 degree.
That is a 3 degree alkyl halide because halogen bonded carbon here, 3 degree carbon, clearly observed. Halogen Br bonded carbon, 3 degree carbon. Because of that reason, it is a tertiary alkyl halide. That is a tertiary alkyl halide. Halogen bonded carbon there, 3 degree. Okay, let's see. Now, tertiary alkyl halide, 3 degree alkyl halides are more favorable for SN1 mechanism. Okay, how to say it is a more favorable? So, before I have given 1 degree, 1 degree alkyl halides are favorable for SN2. Now, here, 3 degree alkyl halides are favorable for SN1. Okay, how to know it is a favorable for SN1? Okay, SN1 means molecularity we want 1. SN1 means we want order equals to 1. Order 1 required, molecularity also 1 required. Such type of reactions are called SN1. Unimolecular reaction or first order nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now listen. Have you seen? Now I have taken one example. It belongs to 3 degree alkyl halide. Clearly we know that. So it reacts with NaOH. NaOH base. Okay. Otherwise alkaline. NaOH mein Na plus and OH minus. Na plus and OH minus. Na plus combined with Br replaced as NaBr. Otherwise, So instead of Na OH, I have taken directly OH minus. Br is eliminated as being Br minus. Br is eliminated as a Br minus. Outgoing halogen, halide ion. Okay, in the place of halogen, which is substituted here?
OH minus.
OH minus is called what we can say?
Nucleophile.
Very good. OH minus is called nucleophile. So it is an example of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Clearly we know that. Okay, given equation is an example of nucleophilic substitution reaction because OH minus is nucleophile. Negative charge is there. This nucleophile substituted in the place of halogen, substituted. So it is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, it is clear? Now listen. It is an example of SN1 reaction. Why? How to say it is a SN1? See here, if we can take this mechanism reaction, generally this reaction does not take place direct to one step. Before I have given, SN2 reaction takes place through how many steps?
One step.
Very good, one step. SN2 is a one-step continuous reaction. SN2. But SN1, what about SN1? SN1 reaction takes place two steps. Why? See, reason. Generally, in step one, first the nucleophile OH minus is there. This OH minus not attack directly this carbon, not bonded directly, but SN2 reaction may have given OH minus directly bonded the carbon. But here not like that. Why? Because SN2 may, if you are observed, we are taking methyl bromide. Methyl bromide means here hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. But here hydrogen's place may, what groups are there? Methyl groups. See, methyl groups are very big groups compared to hydrogen. Compared to hydrogen, methyl, methyl, methyl. See, three big groups are there. Okay, there also halogen, halogen common. SN2 mein, methyl bromide mein. Methyl bromide means here hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Okay, here but methyl, methyl, methyl. Methyl group is the big group. Because of that reason, these four groups are opposed the nucleophile. Why? Because these group electrons, these electrons repelled. These all are big groups. These are look like guards. For this carbon, four strong guards are there. But before molecule, only one guard, halogen, strong guard. But remaining three hydrogens, very weak. That's why their nucleophile easily attack directly. But here the nucleophile not attack directly this carbon because four members are there, strong members, four. Because big numbers, CH3, CH3, CH3. Because due to voluminous of methyl group, sometimes they will give book pay volume, big volume. So compared to hydrogen, methyl volume is the big, size is the big. That's why here the nucleophile not attack directly carbon, not possible, not directly attack. How do it is attack? Okay, because of this big volume means four volumes, okay, surround the carbon. That's why the attacking not possible. In such case, how to the reaction possible? See, step one, first the alkyl halide, tertiary butyl bromide. See, it is a tertiary butyl bromide. If I have taken like this, okay, CH3, here, Br. So it is a tertiary butyl bromide, it is an alkyl halide, tertiary butyl bromide. It is nothing but alkyl halide. Step one, slowly to break the bond between carbon and halogen. First, when we apply the force, pressure, okay, energy here, So with respect to this nucleophile force is there. That's why here halogen partially negative charge, partially positive charge. So first alkyl halide, carbon halogen bond breakings are takes place. Okay, here carbon halogen covalent bond breakings are takes place. It is a which type of covalent bond breaking? Homolytic or heterolytic?
Heterolytic.
Very good. Heterolytic covalent bond breaking. Due to heterolytic covalent bond breaking, what we get? Ions. Okay, when the heterolytic covalent bond breakings are takes place, this halogen take the both electrons because high electronegativity, that is converted into Br minus. Okay, after that, halogen bonded carbon getting which charge?
Positive.
Taken by bromine. Very good.
Positive.
So the carbon getting positive charge because that loses the one electron here. So here it is getting positive charge. This is called carbocation. It is called carbocation. Why? Because if anywhere carbon having positive charge is there, that is called carbocation. Carbon having positive charge is called carbocation. This is the step one. Step one. Already tertiary butyl bromide is a stable molecule. Carbon surrounded, 8 electrons are there. Because of that reason, the reaction takes slow. First, the alkyl halide. Tertiary butyl bromide. It is nothing but alkyl halide. This alkyl halide first converted into carbocation. That is the step one. Now step two. See. Now step two. See. This is the carbocation. Completely deficiency. Carbon having positive charge is there. Plus one. It is nothing but. Then here immediately which one is there? Nucleophile OH minus. Okay, here carbon having positive charge, carbon having complete deficiency. Here nucleophile complete rich. Complete deficiency, they're complete rich. Because of that reason, the reaction takes place slow or fast. It is a complete positive. It is a complete negative. So the reaction takes place very fast. Phosphonate very easily combines. So step two, see. Now the carbocation, carbon having positive charge. This carbocation, see this. Carbocation. Now it reacts, see with. Nucleophile OH minus. Here nucleophile is their second reactant. Nucleophile OH minus. See, it is a OH minus nucleophile. Now here both reacts radially. Why? Because it is a complete negative. It is a complete positive. Here, which side attacking more favorable? Anyone guess that? It is front side or back side?
Back side. Front side.
Any side. See, for example, this carbocation is there. What is the hybridization of carbocation?
SP2
means what is the shape?
Planar.
Very good. SP2 means either carbon. For example, this is the carbon. Planar ka matlab here either A. See? Abhi, three groups. CH3. Abhi, nucleophile. OH minus here. OH minus attack. Either any direction is the same. Why? Because it is attack this side, same repulsions. Otherwise, it is attack this side, same repulsion. There is no difference. The nucleophile attack any direction, attack from this direction, attack from this direction. Why? Because both have same repulsion attractive forces. There is no difference. So this carbon having positive charge total of carbon. So that's why it is attacking from any direction. So it is one of the important point. As SN2 reaction, nucleophile attack from only backside. But as SN1 reaction, nucleophile attack from
any side.
Both side.
Very good. Both sides. Any side. Front and back. So now we get, say, product. Firstly, we get the product. What we get product? If I have taken front side, any direction that is the current. So I will give mechanism also. CH3 here, OH. That is the final product. What is the product name? Tertiary butyl alcohol. It is called tertiary butyl alcohol. Okay, now here, so we want, it is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, clearly we know that. Now after that, it is a SN1 or SN2?
It is a
SN1 or SN2, say? Say that.
SN1.
SN. Okay, how to know that? See, very simple. Okay, this reaction takes place two steps, not direct to one step. Generally, given equation, direct given. But this reaction takes place through how many steps? Two steps. Step one, step two. Out of that, which is the slow step here? First step.
First step.
Very good. First step is the slow step. Slow step is called?
Rate determining step.
Very good. Rate determining step. So here, step one is called rate determining step. So after that, according to chemical kinetics, for example, for this reaction, the rate is directly proportional to, say, the rate is directly proportional to rate determining step participate reactant only. How many molecules are participate?
One only.
Rate determining step may reactants how many? One. What is the name? One. Tertiary butyl bromide. So according to chemical kinetics, rate is directly proportional to tertiary butyl bromide. Therefore, rate equals to K into concentration of tertiary butyl bromide. Say it is a, what is the molecularity of given reaction?
One.
Very good. In a rate of reaction, how many molecules are participate? In a rate of reaction means this one, rate equals to K into tertiary butyl bromide concentration. In a rate of reaction, how many molecules are participate? One. So it is called unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Otherwise, what is the order of given reaction?
One.
Very good. Order equals to one. What is called order? Very simple. In a rate of reaction. In a rate of reaction. What are the sum of the powers? Powers of the concentration terms of reactants. It is the sum of the powers of concentration term of reactant. Here, what is the power? One only. So here power 1 means the order equals to 1. So it is called first order nucleophilic substitution reaction. So finally, see, tertiary alkyl halides are more favorable for SN1 mechanism. Tertiary alkyl halide 3 degree. Okay, generally we can take, this is the equation, principal equation. tertiary alkyl halide plus nucleophile, we get the product. But this reaction not takes place direct to one step. Why? Because this tertiary butyl bromide is central carbon. This one. This carbon surrounded by four big groups are there. Four big groups. Before SN2 reaction, I have given methyl bromide. Methyl bromide ka matlab what I call that here hydrogen, 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 three small hydrogen. That's why the nucleophile directly bonded the carbon. Directly attacked the carbon. But here, not possible that. Because due to four big volume groups are there, so the reaction does not take place directly one step. Okay, it can take place through two steps. Step one, first this alkyl halide, tertiary butyl bromide, step one main. This tertiary butyl bromide, first carbon halogen bond is breaking. Carbon halogen bond is breaking. See, first step one, tertiary butyl bromide, alkyl halide I have given. Okay, carbon halogen bond is breaking. Which type of covalent bond breaking? Heterolytic covalent bond breaking. Because of that reason, here bromine is more electronegative element. We know that compared to carbon. So that is getting negative charge. Br minus. Both electrons are takes by that one. The carbon getting positive charge. This is called carbocation. Carbocation hydrogenation sp2. So that's why I have taken planar shape name. Now it is the step one. Slow step. First alkyl halide already stable. So because of that reason, it is stable, generally not participating in reaction, but here nucleophile pressure is there. That's why it is slowly participate. So step one is the slow step. Okay, step two. This carbocation, complete deficiency. Here immediately a nucleophile is there for attacking. Okay, nucleophile, complete negative, complete positive, radially reacts. Fastly both are combined. We get final product tertiary butyl alcohol. In this process, second step is very fast, positive negative easily combined. So that's why first step is called rate determining step. In this rate determining step, how many molecules are participate? One molecule. The rate depends on that molecule concentration only. Therefore, according to chemical kinetics, the rate is directly proportional to rate determining step participate molecule. What is that? Tertiary butyl bromide. That's why I have taken rate directly proportional to tertiary butyl bromide concentration only. Only rate of reaction may one molecule participate. So it is called first molecularity, unimolecular nucleophilic reaction. Uni, one. That's why I have taken SN1. Otherwise, if you can take the order of the reaction, what is the order of the reaction? One. So, first order nucleophilic substitution reaction. It is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now listen. How is the mechanism? If you can take the mechanism in this process, the nucleophile attack from which direction? Both direction. Any direction is the correct. Now I will take the mechanism. See this mechanism. Okay. So SN2 reaction may how many transition states are formed?
Two.
Very good. Abhi SN2 may have given mechanism may two transition states are formed. But here to form two transition states, how many? Two. So how it is possible? See mechanism. I will explain that is mechanism. See. Abhi mechanism liya to see this. Mechanism. Now here mechanism. So step one. Step one may mechanism may see. Step one. So first tertiary butyl bromide. Tertiary butyl bromide. Okay, it is a tertiary butyl bromide. this one, tertiary butyl bromide. Okay, this tertiary butyl bromide, first slowly to break the bond between carbon halogen partially, first to break the bond slowly, then partially means what about the dotted lines ke denote karna, CH3 here, partial breaking. See, carbon halogen bond partially breaking. Okay, this state is called what we can say, transition state 1, first transition state. TS means transition state. Transition state means we know that unstable means immediately decompose. How to decompose? See this, completely bond breaking means it is converted into Br minus. After that, this carbon converted into carbocation. See, it is a sp3 carbon, planar shape, carbocation. See, this is the mechanism, step 1 mechanism, very simple. Same this one, I have taken tertiary butyl bromide. It is a tertiary butyl bromide. Okay, here once I have break, first we have to break the bond between carbon halogen completely, but mechanism may partially to break the bond. Initially, first to break the bond partially, dotted lines to denote here. After that, completely breaking to form carbocation, same like that only. Step 2. See step 2 mein. Okay, anyone say that step 2 mechanism? What is the possibility? Abhi carbocation. See this, it is a carbocation. So now, nucleophile. Okay, it is attacked which direction? Front or back?
Any direction.
Very good. Any direction. Front less the back leg, because both same. Okay, now first here it is partially formed bond. Partially. Here I have taken completely bond once. Here partially to form the bond. See CH3. Now here bond form OH. See, partially form the bond. Now in this case, then here immediately to form the complete bond, partially bond, then complete bond. It is a transition state 2. Before SN2 mechanism, how many transition states? Transition state, but here two transition states. Now we get complete bond. See, CH3OH. This is the mechanism. Now here important thing, see. So here OH direction, it is a tertiary alkyl halide. Product may dekh lo, OH any direction. Tertiary alkyl halide mein OH bonded. Okay, सेम ब्रोमीन प्लेस में बॉन्ड होने के चांसेस, अगर नहीं तो ऑपोजिट भी बॉन्ड होने के चांसेस, बिकॉज़ बोथ साइड अटैकिंग्स आर फेवरेबल, फ्रंट साइड बैक साइड. ओके, फ्रंट साइड है तो हैलोजन प्लेस में एज इट इज न्यूक्लियोफाइल आ जाएगा, दैट इज कॉल्ड रिटेंशन कॉन्फिगरेशन, नो चेंज. हैलोजन प्लेस में न्यूक्लियोफाइल रिटेंशन, अगर नहीं तो बैक साइड अटैकिंग लिया तो इनवर्शन कॉन्फिगरेशन. सो SN1 मैकेनिज्म में व्हिच कॉन्फिगरेशंस? बोथ retention product and inversion product. But SN2 mechanism mein which product?
Retention.
Inversion.
SN2 mein inversion, opposite only. But SN1 mein do chances.